In this episode of Restore It, I'm going to restore this Hahn Kolb Stuttgart toolbox from sometime in the past. This isn't actually my granddad's toolbox, but one of my good friends, who gave me a bunch of stuff they didn't need anymore as they were moving house. One of those things was this classic looking toolbox that most old men have, full of tools they've collected over the years. This one is in quite bad shape, as we'll find out later on in the episode. I can just about tell it used to be army green underneath all of that rust and patina. And the logo is almost unrecognisable from the outside, but can be seen in reverse on the back of the lid. Along with this toolbox came a load of old tools that I won't be restoring this episode, but some of them I think will make for a nice project one day. The first thing I'm going to do is empty the toolbox and see what's there. There's quite a good amount of space in there once it's empty, and there was actually quite a few tools I know I'll end up using sooner or later, so that was a nice find. So the only thing to do now is to dismantle it and get those cobwebs off. Before I do that, I just have a quick word from our sponsor, Get Roman. As we all know, preparation is the key ingredient in having the confidence that our engine isn't going to blow up during a good thrashing. Whether you've been in a relationship for years or are just getting started, having the confidence that comes from preparation means you're free to enjoy the moment when the moment comes. Even though you may feel far from ordinary, the truth is that ED is a really common thing. The stats say 52% of guys aged 40 to 70 experience some form of erectile dysfunction. With Roman, you can get a free online evaluation and ongoing healthcare for ED, all from the comfort and privacy of your own home. Roman's system is completely confidential and totally discreet. Getting started is simple. Just go to getroman.com/restoreit and complete an online visit. If medication is appropriate, a US licensed healthcare professional will work with you to find the best treatment plan, which ships to you free with 2-day shipping. Make sure you're ready to have the confidence and control this fall with Get Roman. Click the link in the description or go to getroman.com/restoreit today, and if you're prescribed, get $15 off your first month of ED treatment. Big thanks to Get Roman for sponsoring this episode. Let's get back to it. The first thing to remove was the hinges on the lids. I sprayed some WD-40 on them to loosen them up and then tapped them out. As for these old star rivets, I wasn't sure how to remove them, so I started with a cutting disc. Once I had thought about it some more, I decided to move on to the grinder with a flap disc attached. Thank you. With everything apart, I could now more easily see the damage and rust. At this point, I'm starting to think about replacing the bottom of the main compartment. Firstly though, I need to clean and blast every single bit. I'm using the heat gun to speed things up and make sure no moisture is left before blasting. Also, before I blast these small bits, I need to remove the old rivets that got stuck in them. So now I can blast everything. I'm starting on the small parts, using the smaller blasting setup. This works great for those, but for the larger parts, this isn't going to cut it. So instead I'm moving to the pot blaster with the bigger gun, which will make light work of them. The only problem is, it's really hard for my small extractor to keep up with the dust. With everything blasted, I could now see the true extent of the rust and wear damage. The bottom of the main piece just has to go. It's super thin and has many holes in it. Before I remove it, I'm going to straighten up the sides so that it keeps its shape better. As you can see, it's quite all over the place from years and years of use. with it much straighter than it was before. I could mark the lines and make the cut. With that gone, I'm now going to clean up the edges and do a bit more straightening. I can now use the piece I just cut out as a template for the new one. And for those interested, I'm using 18 gauge or 1.2 mm thick steel. I could now weld the new piece in with a series of tacks. I'm now going back over the top of those spot welds with beads to make sure it's definitely going to stay in there. Whilst that filler is drying, I'm going to remove as much of the damage and warping from these smaller parts as I can. To fix this issue, I'm going to drill two holes and plug weld through them. Finally, they were all starting to look a bit more uniform. The lids and small bits are next, and they're pretty heavily bent. This is definitely going to take some time. Whilst I was doing all of that, the filler hardened, which means I can flatten it. I'm not showing you anywhere near the amount of filling that took place, but just know there were multiple layers. Up next, I'm drilling and tapping a hole into the handle. So I can add new bolts that can be removed in the future if needs be. With everything straight enough and the main part filled, I'm going to get some etching primer and high build primer on these to see how things look after. It's much easier to see when everything's one colour. I'm not going to show it to you, but after this point I sanded them back and added some more filler where it was needed. So this is the final coat of high build primer before I flatten it and then move on to the base coat. I'm using 400 grit soft sand pads to flatten the primer. I don't have any army green paint, so I'm going to have to mix some up of my own. I just about got there in the end. I needed a lot more black and yellow than I first thought. With that mixed, I can now paint with it. I then applied two coats of quartz crystal clear lacquer to finish off the painting. They were all then baked with the fast mover infrared heater. With that drying, I could spend some time removing the rust from the washers and the bits that sit inside the hinges. I primed, painted, and clear coated the washers and zinc plated the hinges. So this is the liner I was talking about. I'm going to cut all of the pieces I need, and that should about finish the job. And that's everything restored and ready to be rebuilt. The first thing I'm going to do is stick the liners in using this spray adhesive. Any glue that I accidentally touched onto the paint, I had to let dry before I could remove it with the adhesive remover. With the liner done, I could now rebuild everything. At some point during this rebuild, I realised I had put the washers on the wrong way, and so I went back and sorted it out. And there we have it, the restoration is complete. Well, saying that, I'm going to replace the bolt I used for the handle for a green one made on the lathe. I simply ran out of time to get it in this episode. I know you guys like us to test out the restorations. And this one seems to work great. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one.